I told you prepare a of values beforehand. What are the positive values, what are the negative values, and in any case just you have to decide the permutation combination. Some value from this side, some value from this side, and write 2-3 conflicts. This versus this, this versus this, this versus this. Then the body part, either options would be given or you'll have to generate options. Okay? For each of the options, merits, demerits. Okay? Conclusion part, correct course of action, sequentially, step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4. Then reasons for the correct course of action. Why you are going to do that? Okay, what are the various reasons? Yeah, all the decision premises that we have discussed. Starting from micro level, individual level, the most important is the individual level factors. In every case, you have to focus on micro level, individual level, role of your conscience, role, your responsibility as an human being. Okay? So you have to write those things first. You have to give priority to those things first. Then MISO level, public service values, trusteeship doctrine, fiduciary responsibility, code of conduct, etc. Macro level, violation of any law, policies, international conventions, etc. Indian ethics. Okay. Dharma, Nishtam, Karma, Karma, Kul, Siddhanta, Lok, Sandra. Normative ethical theory, rule utilitarianism, categorical imperative, contractarianism, care ethics, etc. Okay? Then, in some cases, you will be required to use concepts related to emotional intelligence and attitudinal and behavioral change, techniques of persuasion. Okay? This is the superset that you have. In every case, you will have to pick and choose 2-3 factors from this superset and you will have to use in the case. Okay? And whenever possible, try to give examples from the lives of different administrators and thinkers that we have discussed, depending upon the theme of the case. Try to write quotes wherever possible and contemporary examples, contemporary policies and programs. For example, if a case pertains to malgovernance, okay, then you can write what are the reforms that are being implemented by the government to improve governance. When you are writing solutions, when you are writing long-term solutions, AI, etc. This is broadly the framework. Is it clear, this framework? Now, in any case, as you have discussed around six cases, five or six cases, in any case, there are limited number of options that can be generated. In case options are not given and you have to generate options, there are limited number of options can be generated. Okay. The first option is do the wrong thing. Okay. Whatever you are asked to do, which is not ethical, which is not legal, which is not constitutional, do the wrong thing. Okay? That is always an option. The second option is, don't do the wrong thing. But keep quiet. Then you have to write the correct course of action. declare what is the sequence or chronology of correct course of action. First, whenever some wrongdoing is taking place, always the first thing that we need to do is collect evidence. Okay? So that is the first thing that we need. Second, exhaust all internal mechanisms. Okay, exhaust all internal mechanisms mean try to persuade your superior, seek written orders, jump hierarchy, all the internal mechanisms within the organization that are available. Try to pursue your superior, then seek written orders from them. If the superior is not listening, go to superiors above superior, jump hierarchy. Okay. Once all the internal mechanisms have been exhausted, the final option that you will have is whistleblower. Okay. Whistleblowing, where to go? CVC. If CVC is also not responding, or
so CVC can also be state.
No, as per the Whistleblower Protection Act, Whistleblower Protection Act is only for central government. Different state governments will have to pass their own acts. Okay. So at present, the only competent authority is CVC. Okay. If CVC is also not responding, then media or judiciary. Okay? Then you have to give reasons why we will do this. Okay? Why you will do, why you will go through all this pain, why you will take personal pain to collect evidence, exhaust all internal mechanisms, whistleblowing. Why you will do the right thing, then all those decision premises. And finally, long term solution to ensure that such incidents, such issues do not arrive in the or do not happen in the future. Clear? Bas yehi framework har jagah use karna hai. Everywhere. Okay? One template that we had discussed yesterday was that of stakeholder analysis. Where you analyze the impact of each option on each of the stakeholders in terms of pros and cons. Okay, that is that one template that you can use in few cases, one or two cases depending upon the time that you have. Yeah? Sure. We were discussing case 6. So case 6, I think the introduction part we have discussed. Ethical issues we have discussed. Now what are the options? Options have to be generated. Options are not given in the case? Yes. What are the options available to you as the executive director of the company? The first option is accept the resignation. Mrs. X has already resigned. Accept the resignation. Okay. What are the merits and demerits? How will you evaluate this option?
The problem will be solved.
Problem will be solved.
That problem, that particular problem against her sexual assault, will be solved.
Okay. So, to begin with, Mr. A would remain in the company, and because he is a good performer, so it would gain organizational interest. Plus, Mrs. X has already resigned. Okay. So, organization's reputation will also remain intact.
Okay, sure.
In the short term. Given that if she does not say anything outside, assuming that. Okay. What are the demerits?
Work culture.
gender.
She goes outside, after going outside.
Yeah. One possibility is that she has resigned, but she might go outside, she might go to and talk to the media. Okay, then organization's reputation would be undermined.
She might also appreciate.
No, that it's like it's not mentioned, so we cannot assume that. Okay. And plus the demerit would be ethically it is the wrong thing to do. Okay? Because you have a responsibility towards the women employees of the organization as the executive director of the company. Okay. So I mean it's unconscientious.
What culture can be harmful?
What culture can be harmful?
Yes.
Yes. What are the other options as the executive director?
Not accepting the resignation and just to just send her back to
saying
something that you have not experienced.
Second option is basically go soft on Mr. A. Okay. Go soft on Mr. A basically means that try to convince Mrs. X to have a sort of compromise with Mr. A. Try to tell her that okay, these things happen and do not take these things seriously. Okay, so go soft on Mr. A just as a symbolic step. Call Mr. A, thoda sa just scold him in front of her and then ask them to sort the issue amicably. So merit kya hoga? What is the merit of this option? So it's a kind of middle path. Although I am the executive director, so I am showing that I am taking some action against Mr. A. At the same time, I am trying to
deal with
Mrs. X also, and Mr. A also would remain in the organization. So it's in the best interest of the organization. What is the demerit of this option? Again, it's demoralizing for women employees. Anna, they will get the feeling that male employees can do anything and get away with it. Okay, again, work culture. It will have a negative impact on the work culture of the organization. Yeah, that is patriarchal mindset is there. That is there in the first option also. Okay, basically it will give a signal to the male employees that they can get away with any sort of unacceptable behavior. So deterrence would not be created. What the options are as the executive director?
See, transfer and leave.
So, generally, internal actions, just like
the correct option A. That would be part of correct option. I understand what all he needs to do, that would be as part of the correct course of action. We have to generate all the wrong options and reject. Okay, another extreme option that you can do is. Yeah, straight away dismiss Mr. A. Inquiry. Yeah. So another extreme step that the executive director can take is as soon as he receives a complaint from Mrs. X, okay, call Mr. A and dismiss him, or suspend him or take some extreme step. Okay. The merit would be that Mrs. X would be happy that because of her complaint, some strict action has been taken. Okay. However, it is against the principle of natural justice. Mr. A needs to be given a reasonable opportunity to be heard. Mrs. X has told her side of the story. Mr. A also needs to tell his side of the story. Okay. In fact, nowadays, there are a number of instances have come up where there have been wrong cases have been filed, misuse of existing laws, misuse of Dowry Prohibition Act, okay, misuse of sexual harassment at workplace act. Okay. So all the sides need to be heard. An independent inquiry needs to be conducted, then only decision can be right. Okay. Now the correct option. The three options we have generated and then we have rejected. Now what will be the correct course of action as the executive director of the company? What is it that I should do? सबसे पहले क्या करना है? The first step.
First, yes. ask her to withdraw her
resignation. Ask her to withdraw her resignation for the short term.
Hearing both of their
So after getting Mrs. X's complaint,
straight leaving of further to another department.
No. We do not know whether she and Mr. A are in the same department. They are in the same company.
She is the department of the East team.
Okay. Team department. Okay. So you are saying that transfer her to some other team?
Yes.
In the short term?
Yes.
So okay.
Then analyze cost benefit. So, if there are false allegations, there are current allegations. How to check it out? Colleagues, 2 years, 3 years, then 4 years. Then, what are the findings are there? Then, first step is determine the assistant. For example, if somebody has to be there, which means the safety norms, which has to be strictly adhered to. The second one, whatever the results of that particular incident, inquiry. You have to take a soft or tough action according to nature of action, nature of act.
Okay. So yes, the first thing that the executive director needs to do is ask Mrs. X to stay in the company. Okay, assure her that an independent inquiry is going to be conducted. So don't worry on that part. In the short term, as you said, she can be shifted to some other team.
Okay. It leaves to take place then that particular issue might be discussed. Other way. If we handle the long term,
if leave is to take place,
if the director has said he uses a more leave, then she will might discuss this particular issue with the other players. And even if we have some kind of psychological effects, your hand.
The first point is for the condition, he delivers and agrees in the sentence to all the members, including his team. So we need to.
Okay, that would be part of long term solution. The short term solution will be how to deal with this case in particular. Then as part of the inquiry, you will have to assess whether it's a one off case or it's a regular thing that Mr. A does or other way employees do, etc. That would come out in the findings of the inquiry. Okay.
There are chances. If there are no coordination, no communication between two colleagues or the employees, then there can be a possibility of wrong deviations. There can be a basis. So,
there is no coordination.
If there is no coordination between disagreement between two points, any option or
case. Okay, you are saying that there might be disagreement of opinion and then because of that, some wrong, she is filing a wrong case.
There is a possibility.
That's what I said. Nowadays, these laws are being also misused. So, what exactly happened? It will come out only after an inquiry. Okay, so the first thing that the executive director needs to do is don't accept her resignation, ask her to stay, assure her that step would be taken, and she needs to be transferred to some other team. Okay, first thing. Second is call Mr. A, the executive director, the executive director would call Mr. A, ask for his side of the story as to what happened. Okay, and then if prima facie, if it seems that some wrongdoing had taken place, an internal complaints committee need to be set up. In fact, as per the Prevention of Sexual Harassment at Workplace Act, all companies, all organizations with more than 20 members, they have to have an internal complaints committee to deal with such cases. So if such committee is not already in place, it will require to be constituted. Okay. As per the Prevention of Sexual Harassment at Workplace Act. That internal committee is generally headed by a woman. Okay. The internal complaints committee will then conduct an independent inquiry, taking feedback from all the stakeholders, from the peers, from the colleagues, from the subordinates, etc. Then, as you said, it will have to be assessed whether it's a one-off case or Mr. A has been doing it regularly or other male employees have been doing such things regularly. So the extent of problem needs to be assessed. Okay. Depending upon the findings of the inquiry, okay. Appropriate step needs to be taken against Mr. A. Now, what exactly needs to be done? It will depend on the findings of the inquiry. What is the seriousness of the offense? So, the punishment can range from warning, counseling, censure to suspension or dismissal. Okay, so it has to be like punishment has to be proportionate to the nature of the offense. Okay.
Can we seek the transfer?
No. He should not. He is the executive director. See, transfer or leave is for middle management or if you are the head of the institute or if you are the head of a company, then where will you get transferred? You are running the company, you are the executive director of the company. Are you understand?
It's a private company.
It's a private company. Leave by you can go. Yes, leave by you can go. Some other person will like take your charge. So one of the options that has to be rejected, you can write, I might go on leave.
So the options will be maximum 3 to 4.
3 to 4. Incorrect options, not more than 3 to 4. You don't have time to write more than that. Then the correct course of action sequentially. Incorrect options, not more than 3. 3 is fine. 3 is ideal. Maximum 4. Okay. Even if even if there are two options, then also it's okay. But ideal is 3.
Simple.
APR. Yeah, when it becomes part of your APR, then it will become part of your career development. Because APR is used for your career development.
Career development will take place after your time duration. Salary will take place monthly. So you will invite your
salary is something which is difficult to every month you cannot change the salary saying that you did not behave well with that employer. You cannot. Salary is something that is very difficult to change on a monthly basis. But career development, when it becomes part of your official record, then it will affect your career development in the medium to long. Okay? Next. Read the next. Brilliant. Read the case. What is the case about?
Development versus
environment or sustainable development. Okay. Basically, this case pertains to the field of environmental ethics. When we discuss applied ethics, one of the branches of ethics is applied ethics. And within applied ethics, one of the domains is environmental ethics, where we read about these issues, sustainable development, development versus environment. Okay. So here the conflict is essentially between development versus environment, growth versus sustainability. Okay. Now, what exactly are you supposed to do here? Discuss some feasible strategy which could be adopted to eliminate this conflict. So the first part of the case basically focuses on conflict. The first part of the case is saying that many times there is conflict between developmental activities and environment. Okay. So after this brief introduction, what is the case about sustainable development and the conflict is development versus environment versus sustainability. The first part of your answer should focus on highlighting the conflict. You have to give examples to show the conflict. How developmental activities have an adverse impact on environment. Okay. So you can give example of adverse impact of mining, adverse impact of air pollution, deforestation, infrastructure development, how environmental quality is deteriorating. You have to give some real life practical contemporary examples to show that, okay, there is a conflict between developmental activities and environment. Okay. Once you have highlighted the conflict, then comes the solution. Okay. So you have to give some feasible strategies to eliminate this conflict. So basically you have to give feasible strategies for sustainable development. How to achieve sustainable development. Okay? What are the strategies or solutions to achieve sustainable development?
So in this case, can we generate one? Example of mining thing. You can generate a case of
you won't get time to do all this. You have to write the case in it. How many minutes you have to for one case? In total you will have 15 minutes. Given that, if you are able to complete your theory part in 1.5 hours, most of the people are not able to do that. Within those 15 minutes, 4 to 5 minutes in reading the case, understanding the case. So basically you have around 10 minutes to write the case. So don't generate anecdotes and case within case. Okay. That is an essay.
Yes, sir, but even not doing that means not mentioning all the examples, just taking mining as one thing, taking one as the example, and
you can give not to highlight the conflict but as part of solutions. Some case you can give, some example where you can give where environmental concerns and developmental concerns have been preconceived. So instead of giving a case for highlighting the conflict, you can give a case or you can give a practical sort of anecdote where both of them have been preconceived. Because here the focus has to be on solutions. The conflict part is just the introduction part. You are highlighting the conflict. The focus of the answer has to be on strategies and solutions.
So you have an anecdote, you have to choose where you have to use.
Where your anecdotes, yes, for sustainable development, have your anecdotes or examples ready. If any question or any essay related to sustainable development comes, I can use this example or an anecdote to show that, okay, developmental issues and environmental issues can be balanced, can be reconciled. Okay, but here, if you are using that, you won't have the time to write more than 2-3 lines or 3-4 lines. You cannot write an entire case within a case. You won't have time. Essays, you can do that. So, feasible strategies or solutions. What kind of strategies, solutions can be written?
What's the environmental impact assessment? I ask you, are you using the conditions?
Okay.
Go with the development. So, strategies should be always best course of action. Are generating
options? Yeah, but you don't have to generate options. See, again, in every question, you don't have to generate options. That's what I told.
So,
here, what is the question? Read the question.
Are these one of those two cases you have put in exception?
Which two cases? No. See, that was an example that I gave. In general, around 4 out of 6 cases, that strategy can be applied.
In this case?
Here you don't have to see, read the case. What is the question?
It is a feasible strategy.
Yeah, but is the question asking you to generate options, evaluate options? So read the question, you have to use your brain. See, what I have given you is a general framework. You cannot blindly apply this thing in every case. Are you understand? You will have to use, this is not college examination. Okay, so read the question. What is the requirement of the question?
The concept like smart cities. The concept like the smart, smart environment could be okay. But they can be norms. This is a framework. The existence of the environment and the world. You can design the world with the world, as well as the world.
It's not clear what
you
are
Smart city is a concept. Okay, there is a
protocol. What is smart city? What is the concept? See, be very clear about what you are saying. Do not just use terms like that. Okay, because in the interview, if you use terms like this, they will just ask you what you mean. So be very clear about each and every word that you speak. Do you know the meaning of that word? Okay. So smart city has nothing to do with environment. It is about adopting technological solutions for urban development.
Yes. These are technological solutions. Okay. So there are some particular designs and frameworks which have to apply in a particular design of smart cities. Okay. So I am trying to say that there are particular framework. Okay. Which will consider the environmental needs, this developmental needs in sustainable matters. There are
example.
For example, there are green factories. So
green buildings, you are saying.
Now green buildings are other factors, green factories. So which we accommodate.
Basically, what you are trying to say is that sustainable development needs to be institutionalized as part of developmental planning in different sectors. For industrial development, for agricultural development, the idea of sustainability should be part of that sectoral development. For example, your Make in India campaign, or maybe sustainable agriculture, sustainable buildings, sustainable transport.
Yes, clusters, MIDC. I am talking about the city itself. I am talking about the
individual level, providing incentives and providing knowledge about this level.
Okay.
What? Only at the national level, considering real GDP.
Okay.
At the international level also, considering providing incentives.
So you have tried to sort of segregate. See, again, sustainable development is something in which everybody will know. Okay, what needs to be done, what is sustainable development. It again boils down to your presentation, how you are writing your answers. The knowledge is not the problem. The problem is how you are presenting it in a systematic manner. Means is all about answer writing. Okay. So the strategies or solutions to deal with sustainable development, to achieve sustainable development, broadly can be categorized into two parts. Demand side solutions and supply side solutions. Demand side solutions and supply side solutions. Demand side solution kya hai? As you said, the first and the most important thing is to create awareness regarding environmental issues and sustainable development. Because again, environmental issues are generally things where policy makers are reluctant to act. Why?
They don't have the knowledge.
No, they have the knowledge, they know everything.
Yeah.
Don't underestimate
them. They do not consider that.
Why they do not consider these issues as important?
Development
is more important. Electorally, these are not, they will not get them votes. Because if you work on the environment today, its effects would be felt after 10, 15, 20 years. Its effects would not be felt in the short term. So they are not concerned, they just want, like, it would not be visible to the people, to the electorate. Are you understanding? So until, unless there is bottom up pressure, there is sustained public pressure, government would not act on these issues. Okay? So demand side solutions, IEC campaigns, awareness generation, etc., become very important as far as sustainable development and environment. Okay. To create bottom-up pressure so as to force policymakers to act on these issues. A very good example is Delhi's air pollution case. Now, Delhi has had air pollution for a long time. It's not like Delhi's air pollution has suddenly increased. But in the last few years, because of people's pressure, because it has become part of the public discourse, debates and discussions are taking place on the media, okay, newspapers are covering this issue, and there has been a lot of bottom-up pressure. Lot of awareness has been created. That's why the government is now taking various steps to deal with air pollution. So on environmental issues, until unless there is bottom up pressure, there is people's pressure, government will not act. First thing is this. Then once awareness has been created, there is bottom up pressure, then supply side solutions. Okay. What are the supply side solutions?
Demand side.
Kya hota hai? You have to create demand for something. Demand side solutions are always from the point of view of citizens, people. They have to demand. For example, when we talk of governance reforms also, we discuss demand side reforms, supply side, judicial reforms we were discussing. Demand side always means from the point of view of citizens. They have to demand something. Then the government and other entities would provide that, would supply that. Okay, so demand side means through awareness generation, IC campaigns, people have to demand changes as far as environmental issues are concerned. Okay. Once a demand has been created, then the government and other entities would be required to supply or to act. Are you understanding? Now, supply side solutions can be further categorized into different categories. Okay. So we have international efforts. Then national efforts. Then individual efforts. We have so many international treaties and conventions to achieve the objectives of sustainable development. So recently only SDGs, Sustainable Development Goals, have been adopted. So apart from that, we have Paris Climate Change Agreement. We have Convention on Biological Diversity. Under CBD, we have Nagoya Protocol, Cartagena Protocol, etc. For afforestation, we have something called REDD. You have heard of REDD? reducing emissions from deforestation and degradation, REDD. So all these are basically international efforts and international commitments to achieve the objectives of sustainable development. International Solar Alliance, very recently India is a part of ISA. Then national efforts, national level पर क्या क्या किया जा रहा है? Domestically what India is doing? What are the our policies and programs to achieve sustainable development? Yeah, so we have NAPCC, National Action Plan for Climate Change. Under NAPCC we have 8 different missions. NSM, National Solar Mission is one of them.
Okay.
No construction zone areas are there. Yes, no construction zone areas are there. Then NAPCC ke alawa we have SAPCC also, State Action Plan for Climate Change. Okay, to deal with climate change these things are done. Then environmental impact assessment, all those things that we talked about, those will be part of our national efforts. We will see committees, commissions, so many laws are there. Environment Protection Act, Biological Diversity Act, Air Pollution, Water Pollution Act, all these acts and policies and laws are there. Our renewable energy program, our solar energy, wind energy program, efforts have been made to develop renewable energy. Okay, green building code is there. Okay, so what are examples that you were giving from your respective states or from your areas you can quote as part of the national efforts? Domestically, what is being done? Okay, and finally, at an individual level, as a citizen of the country, how can I contribute in achieving the objectives of sustainable development? And so you remember when we were discussing social marketing, I told you that in order to bring about attitudinal or behavioral change on sustainable development, there are multiple things that can be done. And we can do simple things. We can start with doing simple things, switching off fan, light, air conditioners, etc. when they are not in use. Then a little more difficult would be contributing in solid waste management. Okay, segregation of waste at source or installing solar panels on your rooftop. Okay, and then a little more difficult would be to adopt, basically to reduce your carbon footprint by consuming locally locally produced items, products. So as individuals, we can all contribute by doing these things. Are you understanding? See, again, sustainable development is one topic everybody will be able to write something. It's a question of how you are presenting it. If you present it in a systematic manner, writing different headings and subheadings, okay, you'll be able to get that half marks, 1 marks extra. Otherwise, you write strategies for sustainable development, 1, 2, 3, 4. Everybody will do that. Right from day one, I've been trying to sort of convey that. Mains is all about answer writing. It's not a question of your knowledge. Even if you have limited knowledge, you present it, you package it well, you will get good marks. And it does not matter even if you have read, you have done research on sustainable development, if you are not able to write it systematically there in those 7 to 8 minutes, it's of no use. As the examiner, I don't know how much you know. I just have your answer sheet. So always your objective should be whatever you read limited, read it well and answer them well, write them well. That is the most important part. Systematically heading, subheadings. Always try to think systematically. Whenever you are writing reasons, whenever you are writing solutions, heading, subheadings, give examples, current examples, write facts. For example, you can write facts here. There was a committee that was set up. Committee on low carbon strategies for inclusive growth. Okay, a committee on low carbon strategies on inclusive growth. Okay, now the general apprehension is that if we become too particular about environmental concerns, then the economic growth will reduce. That is the general argument, that we will have to spend a lot on dealing with climate change, afforestation, etc. And if we become too particular about environment, then development will suffer. Now, this committee on low carbon strategies for inclusive growth, it conducted a lot of like detailed study and it arrived and basically concluded that in the short run there might be a trade-off between development and environment, but in the medium to long run, okay, adopting low carbon strategies for inclusive growth could result only in reduction in GDP growth rate of around 0.25 to 0.5%. Do you understand? So this is a fact that you can write to convey that there is no conflict between environment and development in the medium to long run. In the short run, there might be a conflict. It might appear that both are contradicting each other, and that if you become concerned about environment and development will suffer. But in the medium to long run, it is in our own interest. Okay, its impact on economic growth would be negligible, 0.25 to 0.5%. Are you understand? So again, you have to write these facts to highlight that sustainable development is actually possible. It's not just a theoretical concept. It is a practical governance necessity, and in the medium to long run, it will not have a negative impact on economic growth. Are you understanding? So again, when you substantiate whatever you are saying with such facts, then your answer becomes like better. Do these simple things instead of reading too much. And reading too much is of no use. You won't be able to write. Okay? Next one. Yeah, but yes. In fact, in many questions in ethics, they have nothing to do with ethics. Don't get confused. This is just one of the cases. There are so many other cases that we are going to discuss. Many cases you will find it has nothing to do with ethics. It's normal JS question. So yeah, that's how it is. So you have to use your JS knowledge. So don't try to don't get confused with ethics care, what ethics were. Ethics just through introduction, I told you it's part of environmental ethics. That is the only thing that you can write. There is no ethical issue here otherwise. Okay. Are you in the case? Normal citizen, you are just a friend, and your friend who also aspires for civil services, he is seeking your advice on such. So how will you introduce the case? What general introduction can you write here? Common misconceptions with regard to the need for and importance of ethical standards in public life. Despite temptation. Okay, those things we will write when we are going to analyze the option. I told you, the introduction has to be generic. Do not try to include the facts of the case in the introduction. Okay. Now, what is it that you have to do? Basically, for again, you don't have to generate options, you don't have to evaluate options. Here, four point of views are given, you just have to analyze these four point of views and give your advice to your friend. Okay? So, first, point of view kya hai? In the present times, when unethical environment is quite prevalent, individual attempts to stick to ethical principles may cause a lot of problems in one's career. It may also cause hardship to the family members as well as risk to one's life. Why should we not be pragmatic and follow the path of least resistance and be happy with doing whatever good we can? Why should you not be pragmatic? Well, you should be pragmatic and follow the path of least resistance. So this point of view or this option has two parts. Okay? In the first part, what is the option saying? That if you try to be ethical, then it might create a lot of problems for your career. Right? So, what are the problems that are caused if you try to do ethical? Victimization, harassment, transfers, posting, frequent transfers, etc. What kind of examples can be given here? So again, see, you have to address each and everything that is being written in the option. You know? Although the question is why should we not be pragmatic and follow the path of least resistance? But the first part of the option also you have to address. The first part of the option is saying that it will lead to a lot of problems. So you have to give examples to show that if you try to be too ethical, then it causes a lot of problems. You know? So you have to give examples, Ashok Khemka, G.R. Khairnar, all those examples that we have discussed. And you have to pick and choose from those examples, okay, which were the civil servants who were victimized and harassed because they chose to follow ethics. Clear? Then the second part. Why we should not be pragmatic and follow the path of peace resistance and be happy with doing whatever good we can? यहाँ पर आउट ऑफ सिस्टम का बात नहीं, यहाँ पर इन द ऑप्शन में लिखा है कि विद इन द सिस्टम और आउटसाइड द सिस्टम. यहाँ पर बस द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाई यू शुड नॉट बी प्रैक्टिकल एंड फॉलो द पाथ ऑफ लीस्ट रेजिस्टेंस इंस्टेड ऑफ बीइंग टू एथिकल एंड सफरिंग विक्टिमाइजेशन. जस्ट डू व्हाटएवर यू कैन एंड बी हैप्पी एंड प्रैक्टिकल, डोंट बी टू आइडियलिस्टिक, डोंट बी टू एथिकल. दैट इज द क्वेश्चन. Yeah, that is it.
You should reduce the merit.
Again, you don't have to write merit, demerits here. Yahan par kahin likha is the question asking you to evaluate. You don't have to write merit, demerit. You just have to analyze what kind of option it is, whether you agree with it or not. If you don't agree, why you don't agree. You have to give advice to your friend. Okay. So why you should not follow the path of least resistance? What is wrong with this option? Or do you agree with this option? Do you agree with this option?
No.
No?
It would be willful load of violation of willful load of office.
Willful violation of
the public servant.
See again, in any question, why you should do a right thing or why you should not do a wrong thing, the available options are what? All those decisions. Why you should not follow the path of least resistance? Because again, at the level of your conscience, it is against public service values. It's part of your my dharma not to follow the path of least resistance. And a categorical imperative. See again, that's what I'm trying to convey in every case. The content is the same. If you start thinking new things in the examination hall, okay, it will take a lot of time and you'll waste a lot of time. That's why you have to prepare your content beforehand. It's just a question of applying that content in different cases. So in any case, why you should do the right thing or why you should not do the wrong thing, the answer is the same. Micro level, ISO level, macro level, Indian ethics, normative ethics, they march there. Ab usme se, don't write all the facts. Write 2-3 on that. Are you understand? The sooner you understand this, the better it is for you. Otherwise, you will keep on searching for new answers in every case. The answer remains the same. My teacher had once told me this sentence, and I remember it till now. Whatever be the question, answer is the same. In everywhere, in every topic. Because in every topic, the correct, what needs to be done remains the same. Irrespective of the question from that topic, this is only what needs to be done. Now you have to just change the language, presentation, etc. But the content will remain the same. Are you understand? So do not try to unnecessarily complicate things. Study limited things, just apply them. Next. When so many people are adopting wrong means and are grossly harming the system, what difference would it make if only a small minority tries to be ethical? They are going to be rather ineffective and bound to get frustrated. You agree with this option? No? Why you don't agree? What is the issue with this option? Which is the fallacy here? We discussed fallacies. Means versus end is okay. This is the fallacy. Okay. So, yahan par your friend is saying that just because everybody is doing it, therefore it is ethical.
Two right things cannot make, two wrongs cannot make a right.
Yeah, two wrongs do not make a right. Also, yahan par you can also write moral conventional. Okay. So, here basically what he is saying that many people are adopting wrong means and grossly harming the system. So, basically it has become part of our society. It has become part of our culture. Okay. Therefore, it is right. Yeah. So, it suffers from the fallacy of moral conventionalism. Just because it has become part of our culture, just because everybody is doing it, does not make it right. Okay.
So, we need not to mention moral conventionalism.
You can mention, just explain. What is, do not just write it suffers from moral conventionalism, explain what moral conventionalism.
Without writing that also?
Without writing that also, you can. Just because it's part of our culture, just because everybody is doing it, does not make it right. Okay. Now you have to give examples. Again, you do not have to stop at theory. Always you have to give examples. So you can write quotes here, you can give examples here. For example, you can give quotes such as, the history of the world is nothing but the story of few men who believed in themselves. If they would have thought that what will happen because of my efforts, then changes would not have been brought about. So give examples of Gandhi, Mandela, Abraham Lincoln, Martin Luther King Jr. If they would have also believed in this thing, that everybody is doing the wrong thing, so why I should do the right thing, then world would not be what it is today. The history of the world is nothing but the story of few men who believed in themselves. Men, women. Okay. So, basically, just because others are doing something wrong, it does not give a justification for you doing the same thing. You have to do the right thing. You have to always stay on the correct course of action. Okay. Then give examples of other people. Give quotes. For example, वो गांधी का एक quote है ना, first they laugh at you, then they fight you, then they insult you, then you win. इस तरीके का है, तीन चार चीजें ऐसी. Okay, so basically this quote basically shows that you should follow ethics and strong value system. It should not matter what others are doing, है ना? If you follow the right path, okay, others will laugh at you. Okay, then they will fight you. But ultimately you will win. Okay. So you should write these quotes and these examples in your answers. Theory just 2-3 lines, then these examples and quotes. First they ignore you, then they laugh at you, okay, then they fight you, and then you win. Then you can give examples from civil services. Okay, people who believed in themselves and did not follow the path of least resistance. We have discussed so many examples. You know, the IITN session, S.R. Sankaran, etc. Give those examples. These civil servants devoted their entire life to the cause of public service. They did not follow the path of least resistance. They were not satisfied in doing whatever good they can. They always upheld public interest. They always gave more importance to public interest over private interest. ये एग्जांपल कितने हैं क्लियर नेक्स्ट इफ वी बिकम फसी अबाउट एथिकल कंसीडरेशंस विल इट नॉट हैम्पर द इकोनॉमिक प्रोग्रेस ऑफ अ कंट्री आफ्टर ऑल इन द प्रेजेंट एज ऑफ हाई कंपटीशन वी कैन नॉट अफोर्ड टू बी लेफ्ट बिहाइंड इन द रेस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड क्या कह रहा है ये व्हाट इज दिस ऑप्शन अबाउट व्हाट इज डिस्पेंसिंग listen or you don't revise whatever is going on. So I told you that the argument that ethics is not compatible with economic development, it is not correct. It is fallacious argument. Okay, and then you will have to give examples and facts to show that this argument is not correct. Okay, for example, I have given you the size of the black economy. Black economy, all example, yeah, the underground economy. What is the size of our black economy?
70%.
More than 70%. Okay, and why this black economy exists? Because of corruption, because of lack of ethics. So, if ethics, ethical framework of our economy would have been strong, then this 70% would have been part of our formal economy. Are you understanding? Which would have boosted the process of economic development. Do you understand? I have given some data that research suggests that corruption basically, which is a symbol of lack of ethics, okay, it undermines investment by 5 to 10% and economic growth by 0.5 to 1% or 0.25 to 0.5%. So these facts you have to write to show that there is no incompatibility between ethics and economic growth. In fact, ethics is needed for economic growth. Ethics actually facilitates economic growth and development. So ethical governance is a part of good governance, and there is a positive causal correlation between good governance and developmental outcomes. And ethics in governance is a part of good governance. It is one of the components of good governance. Remember the components of good governance? I told you probity in governance, ethics in governance is one of the parts. And good governance is one of the prerequisites for developmental outcomes. In fact, a World Bank study shows, like, it conducted research in 150 countries across the world. And those countries which had a strong governance framework, they rank better in SDI indicator, Human Development Index indicator. It shows that those countries which have a strong governance framework, they have better developmental indicators also. And by strong governance framework, we mean one of the components is ethical governance or ethics in governance. All these examples and facts you have to write to show that there is no inconsistency between economic development and ethics. Ethics is actually needed. I'm going to give the examples of recent scams and scandals. So because of these illegal and unethical activities of the private sector, how the government is being robbed of its legitimate revenue, for example, tax evasion, transfer pricing, etc. If those revenues the government receives, then it could be spent for economic development, infrastructure development, social sector development, etc. So because of lack of ethics, the government is being deprived of the revenue that it would have received, which would have been spent on economic growth and development. These examples, again, all this is your GS knowledge. There is nothing ethical, like ethics ki theory yahan par kuch nahi hai. There is no theory involved here. You have to use your brain just. You have to use your basically your GS knowledge here. Next. It is understandable that we should not get involved in grossly unethical practices, but giving and accepting small gratifications and doing small favors increases everybody's motivation. It also makes the system more efficient. You agree with this view?
Same. In the short term, benefits, but you want everyone to start.
Yes. So it's a slippery slope. Once you start accepting and giving small favors, you don't know where to stop. Then small favors will become big favors, you won't even realize. Okay? Then, yes, as you said, you can quote rule utilitarianism. What will happen if everybody has a rule? Start doing the same thing. What will happen? Incidental corruption will become institutional corruption, and institutional will become systemic. Okay? In fact, giving and accepting small favors, it's part of culturally sanctioned corruption. Remember, we have discussed culturally sanctioned corruption. socially sanctioned corruption. So I told you that in India, like giving and accepting small favors is considered to be socially acceptable. And that is one of the reasons for why corruption has become entrenched in our system. Because we do not consider it as wrong. So it will lead to socially sanctioned or culturally sanctioned corruption. Incidentally, corruption will become systemic corruption.
Okay. Here. Next case. For each and everything, you just have to reject what these are his beliefs. You just have to reject his beliefs, and then you have to give explanation why this belief is wrong. Why this is wrong? It's a slippery slope argument because it will lead to it, because incidentally it will become institutional. System. This argument is wrong because ethics does not hamper economic development, but it actually facilitates, and then give examples.
Sorry.
And lastly, in the conclusion part, just reiterate the public service values. Your advice to your friend should be that if you want to join the civil services, then you better start believing in these public service values. Trusteeship principle, fiduciary responsibility, subordination of individual interests in favor of public interest, etc. These are the values which as civil services aspirant, we should believe in. Okay, so get rid of these misconceptions that you have. Start following these values in your life. This should be your advice to your
friend. So, politically analyzed, that means we have to show the favor of the points also.
No problem.
Critical analysis does not mean. Critical analysis means you should evaluate the option holistically. Now, if it's a wrong option, how can you write a positive point? That option.
Means it favors a person, then first we should mention the merits, then
every option won't have a merit. Critical analysis means just analyze. See, again, don't get confused by these terms. I think I've told you this. Critical analysis, analysis, examine, analyze, all these things mean the same thing. Except two words.
Elaborate
and expand. Usme just you have to follow whatever is being asked in the question. You have to write this from one dimension. In all other questions, just analyze. See, if some option is wrong, what your friend is saying is wrong, you cannot highlight a positive. I understand. Critical analysis means analyze the option. If it is wrong, then explain why it is wrong. Do not just write it is wrong. Give examples, give facts. Next.
After some time you will become frustrated.
again, you don't need to think about these things now. Because under the same sentence, then think about these things. Anyway. So, what is the case about? How will you introduce the case?
Combination of all these options. Okay, so first thing is
initiate disciplinary proceedings, okay, and let an independent inquiry be conducted, okay, as to what they have done. Second thing is cooperate with the inquiry of the commission. Okay. Third thing is take the advice of their superiors. Let them know what has actually happened.
Okay. So here also we need to do the merits and demerits. Means it is not necessary to do the merits and demerits.
Yeah. Yes. That's what I am telling you.
It
is not necessary. So for example, we have to analyze. See, what is what we have to do? We have to analyze or evaluate the option. How the option is. So we are saying that the first part of the option is fine, but the second part is not correct. Why it is not correct?
Just one not good.
You have to give reasons also. Why some option is right, or why you would follow something, or why you would not follow something, you have to give reasons also. You don't just write, okay, I will do this, but I won't do this. Why you won't do that? You also have to explain that. Okay? I think it's a very simple case. Yeah, but all the options are already given. Because when there are, and the best course of action is just a combination of all those three options.
Yes, that's suggesting another possible options.
I don't think there is another possible action. You can do these three things only. Because a false case has been imposed on you. Okay? So an inquiry has to be conducted. An inquiry will be conducted because the case has been registered against you. In the inquiry, you will come out as innocent. Okay, so cooperate with the commission. There would be no evidence against you because you have done no wrong. Okay. Disciplinary proceedings you have to initiate against those who are creating trouble within the organization. Okay. And you have to take the help of your superior or advice of your superior. One thing that you can do in such cases is networking with honest people within the organization. Honest and like-minded people. Okay? Networking with honest and like-minded people in the organization. Both in the short term also and in the long term also. See, you have to be practical. You also have to protect yourself. You are an honest man. But as you will realize, just honesty is not enough. You have to be smart also. If you are just honest, then throughout your life you will be victimized and harassed. Okay. So the moment you enter any of government organization or for that any organization, you should try to identify who are the good people in the organization. See, in any organization there will be honest people, dishonest people, good people, bad people. You are an honest person. Okay. So you should identify, okay, these three, four people. They could be part of your colleagues, or they could be superiors, they could be subordinates, anybody. You should try to build good relationships with them. Okay, you should be on good terms with them. So that whenever a situation arises, when you are in trouble, when someone is framing you or you are being victimized, harassed, they should come to your rescue. Okay, so this is very important. So this should be the long term solution, even in the short term. Go and talk to people so that when the Women Commission is doing the inquiry, those people will give evidence in favor of you. They will tell you, they will tell the commission that he is an honest man. He has never done anything like that before. So honesty is fine. You have to be smart also. You should build good relationships also within the organization. I am not saying build good relationship with corrupt people, unethical people, with the honest people. So that they support you when the time comes, as and when the need arises. So it is very important for the honest people within an organization to be united. And today I am being victimized, tomorrow somebody, some other honest person will be victimized. So they have an interest in staying united and helping each other out when that time comes. Okay. So this is one practical solution that you can give in such cases. Next. Combination of the three options would be the best course of action. That's it. Because this case is a little bit simple. I mean, there is nothing else. Can you think of anything else? See, these are the things which I would think of. If you can think of anything else, you can add that. Anything else can be done here? Or kuch kar sakte hain aap? I would not think of anything. There is no need to complicate. These are the few simple things you do and just have a
have faith in the system.
So that's what I'm saying. If you can give up something, you can act. Whatever I'm saying is what I have thought. Because I don't know everything. I cannot think of everything. So you can keep on adding to whatever I'm saying. Next.
Have you read the case? So what is the case about? Who are you?
CEO.
So you are part of private sector. You are not a public sector employer. Okay. What is the question? Valid arguments can be advanced for giving the bribe, getting the order, and for refusing the waiver bribe, refusing to pay the bribe, and risking the loss of the order. What are those arguments? Okay. Is there a third way to get out of the dilemma? So first of all, how will you introduce the case? What is the case about? This case is about coercive corruption in public procurement. Remember types of corruption? Coercive, collusive. So it's a case of coercive corruption. Because the CEO is being forced to pay a bribe. And it's a case of public procurement. So coercive corruption in public procurement. Simple eight-line introduction. It sort of captures the essence of the case. In fact, the introduction should be such that it can be used in other cases also. Now, this introduction can be used in other similar cases also. Ethical conflict kya hai yahan par? Which are the values in conflict? Organizational benefit, organizational interest versus
individual
ethics. Corruption versus honesty or integrity versus professional advancement. Means versus end. What is the end objective here? Not just the contract, but the end objective is basically survival of the organization. It's written that the contract is important for the improvement of your company. Not getting the order would mean closing a production line. It may also affect your own career. So the end objective is protecting your career as well as the future of your organization. But again, what are the means that you are going to achieve to do that? So means versus end.
Now, what are the arguments? You have to write two things: arguments for giving the bribe, arguments against giving the bribe, and then a third way. Okay? What are the arguments for giving the bribe? So you can write in terms of impact on different stakeholders. So I will be benefited, my organization will be benefited, the government employee will be happy. The employees will be happy. So that's what I'm saying. In terms of impact on different stakeholders. Then the government servant will be happy, and if the government servant will be happy, then he might help you in getting future contracts also. So it's a win-win situation for everybody. Everybody is happy. So you should do it. Also, it is not unfair to his competitors. Competitors are also one of the stakeholders. Other people who are bidding for the contract, for the order. Now, it's written in the case that your order is the most deserving one. Both the quantity and cost of your offer are better than those of the competitors. Yeah, so this paying the bribe to get the contract is also not unfair to the other bidders, because as it is, your order is the best offer. Are you understanding? So generally, in such cases, one of the arguments against is that it's unfair to the competitors. For example, who interview wala, you remember? Because if you give favor to this person, then it would be unfair to other candidate. Here, this is not the case. Because your offer is the best offer, so one of the arguments for giving the bribe is that it is also not unfair to the other bidders. Okay? Because you are the most deserving bidder. Clear? What are the arguments against? Because it's written here that you are a value conscious person. So when a value conscious person will be forced to give a bribe, what will happen?
In future he may lose his values.
Yeah, it will give you. What is the term that we use? Cognitive
dissonance.
So if it will lead to cognitive dissonance in his head, so either he will get rid of his old values and he will turn into a corrupt person, then it will become a habit for him. Okay.
Two possibilities. Cognitive dissonance one thing, and other thing he may change.
As a result, cognitive dissonance is a transitory stage. So when that conflict will arise, one of the possibilities is that he will get rid of his old values. He will be robbed of peace of mind, etc. He is a very individual developer. Professionally also, if the matter comes to light in the future, it's a violation of Prevention of Corruption Act. Giving a bribe is a violation of Prevention of Corruption Act. So tomorrow, if it comes to light that he had paid a bribe to get the contract, he can be prosecuted. So professionally also, his and his organization's reputation and future can be in jeopardy. Plus, at a larger society level, at a larger systemic level, it will encourage systemic corruption. Because it will encourage similar, like it will encourage that government employee and similar such employees to ask for bribes. If I as the CEO of the company, if I pay a bribe, then that government servant will be encouraged and motivated to do with other people as well. So it will sort of lead to systemic corruption, institutional and systemic corruption. Okay? So these are the arguments for, arguments against. Now third way. Is there a third way to get out of the dilemma? See, third way basically means correct course of action. What will you do? What is the correct course of action? That is a long conversation. What you can not do online bidding. What will you do as the CEO of the company? If you are facing such a situation, what will you do?
Rejecting the things known.
How? If you reject, you won't get the contract.
Reject means that's like this.
And you tell me.
It's not the words.
That is the last resort always. The first thing that you need to do is first talk to the government employee. Try to persuade him, try to convince him. He try to tell him that whatever he is doing is wrong. Okay? And you can threaten him also that he might have to face the consequences, etc. Basically, use all techniques of persuasion. You know, you have to use different techniques, cognitive, affective, behavioral group. Jitne bhi techniques hai, use that. वहाँ पर आपको अपना थ्योरी का नॉलेज यू हैव टू यूज है ना, यूज योर थ्योरी का नॉलेज. इन ऑल प्रोबेबिलिटी इज नॉट गोइंग टू अग्री है ना. देन द नेक्स्ट ऑप्शन इज दैट यू कैन अप्रोच द सुपीरियर है ना. बिकॉज सी इन एनी केस ऑफ पब्लिक प्रोक्योरमेंट और गिविंग अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट द डिसीजन मेकिंग इज नॉट कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड इन वन हैंड. देयर आर अदर पीपल आल्सो इन्वॉल्व. सो ट्राई टू आइडेंटिफाई दोस पीपल.
It should be the
last. Yeah. Who are the people working in that organization, in that department, who are the good people, try to identify them, try to talk to them, so that they could persuade this government officer to do the right thing. Okay. Once all internal mechanisms have been exhausted, nobody is responding, the government officer is not listening, his superiors are not listening, nobody is listening, then you can blow the whistle. But again, for whistleblowing, first of all, you need to, as you said, collect
evidence.
Because if you go out and shout that, okay, he is demanding bribe, nobody is going to believe you until unless you have. Yeah. So, in order to prove that he has done something wrong, okay, you need to have evidence. Okay? Then you can listen. Okay? How will you collect evidence? He is not your boss. Written orders are in place when your superior, when your boss is asking you something. Yeah, so evidence collect karne ke se bahut tarike hain, there are various means. One of the means is sting operation. Now sting operation is a separate topic in itself. What are the ethical issues involved in sting operation? You can get a question in ethical issues in sting operation. In fact, when the AAP government came to power, when Arvind Kejriwal came to power, one of the first things that he did was asking people to conduct sting operations if government servants ask right from them. Okay. So sting operation is actually, it has happened. I mean, it's not just a theoretical sort of suggestion. The AAP government has actually asked people, if any government servant asks right from you to conduct a sting operation, they had set up a separate department, okay, to collect all such evidences, recordings, etc. Okay. However, as far as sting operations are concerned, there are various rules which are required to be followed before conducting a sting operation. Okay. In fact, there are guidelines of NBA, News Broadcasters Association. Okay. What are the principles that should be followed with regard to sting operation? A sting operation is again a very, it's an ethical minefield. Okay. So you can go through the guidelines of NDA with regard to sting operations. I'll just tell in brief what are those guidelines. Okay. So basically, sting operation, jo hai, it should be, first of all, it should be carried out only when public interest is concerned. Okay. It should not be carried out for settling personal scores or for personal reasons, only when a larger public interest is concerned. Secondly, it should be carried out only as the last resort. When all other options have been exhausted and the conventional methods have been exhausted, then only sting operation should be carried out. Thirdly, and most importantly, sting operation should not induce somebody to do something. Are you understand? So, you should not encourage somebody to do something wrong and then capture that thing on the camera. For example, honey trapping, even recent cobra post. You heard of cobra post? Recent sting operation cobra post? A few months back only it happened. So cobra post sting operations were basically
there was a small media organization. It was conducting a sting operation. So basically what they did, their journalists went to different popular media houses and all the big media houses, Times Group, etc. They went there and they told their head that if those media houses support a particular political party in the next year elections, and they publicize that party, that ideology, etc., then they would receive a lot of monetary benefits. Okay. And on camera, as in they did not know that they were being recorded, they agreed to it. They agreed, okay, for itna, for this much of money, we will support a particular party or ideology. Now the issue with this Cobra post was this only, that you were inducing them to do something wrong by offering them money. Are you understanding? They did not come to you and tell you that, give me money, then I will do this. So there is a difference. Sting operation should be used to capture only those things which the other person, other entity would have done. Otherwise also, you are just capturing their wrong. You are not encouraging them, provoking them, instigating them to do something wrong. And a first user, do that thing, and then you destroy it. Okay.
Years back, media became a major minister. His name is D.K. Shivakumar. And he found that they were here to conduct such things. And then he locked them into a single room, in a single room. He sent his persons to the region.
Yeah. So this is one of the most essential principles that need to be followed in sting operation. Okay? It should not induce somebody to do something wrong. Also, once a sting operation has been conducted, its recordings should be preserved. Full recordings should be preserved for a period of 90 days. Okay. Otherwise, what media houses generally do? They show sting operations very selectively. And only select portion of the entire recording they will show as per their convenience. They will not show the entire recording, what has happened. So that's why it is very important that the recordings should be preserved for a period of 90 days so that if it needs to be assessed, what is the entire picture, what exactly happened, it can be assessed. Are you understanding? So these are some general guidelines or general principles which should be followed if at all a sting operation is going to happen. So go through the guidelines of NPA. You can get a question on ethics of sting operations. Okay? Yeah, then as a long-term solution, the solution that you were talking about, how to ensure that such instances do not happen in the future. So, e-procurement, electronic procurement, human interface should be eliminated. In fact, e-procurement is being done in various government departments, in various states. Okay, so you can give those examples, how the government is trying to eliminate corruption in such cases of public procurement through
Government
e-marketplace. E-marketplace is not exactly public procurement. E-procurement, go just read about e-procurement, you will find. E-procurement is a program under NEG, or it was a program under National E-Governance Plan. Okay, those current examples you can give. What is the government doing to deal with such? Next.
You are also not resting public authority.
Yeah, collegium system. Collegium system, even if it is taking place manually, one individual should not have all the powers to decide who will get the contract. So, committee system instead of individual decision. Okay? Next. the case. What is the case about? How do you introduce the case? What is the case about? Fearlessness versus risk of victimization. है ना? कि whether to be fearless or get victimized and harassed. ठीक है? See again, these conflicts, you have to write, pick up something from the positive value, pick up something from the negative values and write the conflict. ठीक है? ठीक है? Now, what are the various options that are available in the situation? You have to generate different options, evaluate and choose the correct course of action. ठीक है? First option क्या है?
Following the superior's orders.
So the first option is getting actively involved in the wrongdoings. कि whatever wrongdoings are taking place, you also get involved in the same. So how will you evaluate that option? Correct क्या होगा? Everybody is happy. You are happy, your superior would be happy, your professional career development would not be negatively affected. It's a win-win situation for everybody. What is the demerit? All those things. First of all, because again, yahan par likha hai ki Rameshwar is already feeling disillusioned and uncomfortable. It shows that he is an honest person. So again, cognitive dissonance. When an honest person would get involved in some wrongdoing, it would lead to cognitive dissonance, unconscientious, okay, public service values, unconscientious against his conscience, okay, violation of public service values, prestige and doctrine, etc. Okay. Because again, professionally also, if this issue comes to light, tomorrow if these irregularities come to light and it becomes known that Rameshwar was also involved, then professionally also, those will be reached. Not just personal image, professionally also, actions would be taken against him. Disciplinary proceedings might be initiated against him. Okay? So both ethically as well as professionally, okay, this is not the right thing. Okay? Second option क्या है?
Doing anything, go and just wait.
Yeah, don't do anything. Keep quiet as taking advice. Don't get involved in wrongdoing.
you don't yourself misuse the resources, don't be like, don't engage in corruption, but don't act also. Keep quiet. Merit kya hua is option ka? What is the merit? Personal satisfaction that at least you are not personally involved. So that personal guilt might not be there. That okay, other people are doing it, at least I am not personally involved. Plus, professionally also, it would be it would hamper because at least he is not creating problems for others. And he is keeping quiet, so his behaviors won't be too concerned about him. No victimization, no harass. What is the demerit? It's a willful act of omission. Although you are personally not involved, but you are ignoring some wrongdoing. Lack of courage of conviction. Lack of integrity. Absence of strength of character. Okay? Third option kya hai? Leave, transfer, resign. Either go and leave, get yourself transferred or resign. Now going on leave is not going to solve the problem, because once he comes back, then he will have to face the same issue. Transfer, it can help depending upon the new organization where he is transferred, whether their corruption is prevalent or not, or if there is corruption, what is the extent of corruption. So transfer may or may not help, if not. Resigning might help. Resigning is always an option. If there is too much of corruption in your organization and you are not able to handle it, then you better resign. Okay. But the demerit of these options would be? Same. Lack of courage of conviction, lack of leadership, lack of strength of character. It is not what ethical civil servants, public servants are supposed to do. They are supposed to take responsibility for changing things. Civil servants are change agents. Okay. After rejecting all these options, then correct course of action. Before correct course of action, briefly just analyze the nature of irregularities that are taking place in the organization. What all is taking place in the organization? Funds are being misappropriated. What is it? It's a violation of Appropriation Act. Not money laundering. Misappropriation is different from money laundering. Misappropriation is not using it for the purpose for which it was given. So funds under various schemes and grants were being misappropriated. They were not being used for the purpose for which they were given. It's a violation of Appropriation Act. Appropriation Act, you remember? And GFR, General Financial Rules. So again, you have to be very specific as to what exactly is taking place in the organization in your answer. Okay. So which rules have been violated, you should know. Okay. Then the official facilities are being used for personal needs. What is the problem here? What is being violated? Yeah. So it's a violation of trusteeship doctrine, because those resources have been given to you as part of public trust. So if you are using public resources for private purpose, it is violation of trusteeship doctrine. And basically, or kya hai, cheating. Cheating in recruitment. Now it's a very serious offense. Cheating in recruitment is a legal offense. It's an offense under Prevention of Corruption Act. Okay. And it has implications not just for the organization but for the entire society. Because these people who are being recruited, they will be posted in different organizations in the government. Okay. So it's a very serious issue. After analyzing the seriousness of the irregularities, next is correct course of action. Sabse pehle kya karna hai?
Generate options, later these things. So firstly, generate the options.
As part of correct course of action, what will you do? As Rameshwar, the first step, that what will you do? Yeah, generated different options, rejected them, we have analyzed the irregularities. Now we have to write the correct course of action.
We have to pursue it. We have to communicate.
There was acting strictly with these things.
So first,
the first thing that you need to do is collect evidence. Okay, Rameshwar first of all needs to collect evidence against all wrongdoings that are taking place. Okay, ek bar once you have evidence, then you have something to back on. Okay, next is then talk to your superiors, other colleagues, other peers.
So first we restrict means whatever the thing we try to implement them. After opposition by those things require because superiors tell us to do the thing.
That is already you have been told. That is clear in the case. Your superior has asked you to keep your mouth shut, not to do. So everybody is involved. That is clear in the case. Okay. So first thing is collect evidence regarding their irregularity. Second thing, talk to your superiors, other people who are involved. Try to persuade them. You can use different techniques of persuasion. You can use your theoretical knowledge. In all probability, they are not going to be persuaded. Yeah, because persuasion say, koi fark padega nahi. Okay. Then you can jump the hierarchy. You can go to the superiors above your superior. Tell them what is happening in the organization. All these irregularities are taking place. Request him to take some action.
Sir, in the persuasion thing, can we see the written orders? There is.
No, yahan par written orders ka baat nahi na, because you are not being forced to do anything. Written orders you will see only when somebody is asking you to do something. Yeah, but you are not doing, but these are things which are going on around you. So there is no question of written order.
You observe these things.
Yeah, you observe these things. So you can jump the hierarchy, go to the superiors above your superior, tell them as to what is happening in the organization, try to convince them. Okay? If they get convinced, fine. If they don't get convinced, and all other internal mechanisms have been exhausted. You have talked to your superior, colleagues, subordinates, superiors above superior. Everybody you have talked to, nobody is responding. Everybody is asking you to keep quiet. Okay, then what we can do? For whistleblowing, you have the evidence. Okay? And why you will do this? Why you will go through so much of effort and risk of victimization? Why you will do this? Why you will not adopt the easier path? All those decisions are myself. It's part of my karma, it's part of my categorical imperative. Okay, I'm a public servant, I'm supposed to uphold public trust.
So by mentioning the categorical imperative, just we can mention that one should do his duty in the world.
Categorical imperative you can write. Just see, whenever you are using these terms, first of all, use these terms at very less places. Okay? And whenever you are using them, just explain one line. What is categorical imperative? Doing one's duty without fearing about the consequences. And do not just use the term. And explain it in one or two lines. Okay? Whenever you are using those theory terms. Okay? Well, we will do later. In the 30, we will take a break for 5 minutes, and then we will continue. 1 o'clock, we will meet. Okay? See, are you getting a hang of how to approach case studies? See, in most of the cases, we are following the same approach: introduction, body, conclusion. How to generate the number of options that can be generated are limited. Evaluation of those options we have discussed. Every option, how is to be evaluated. Correct course of action has to be written sequentially. Okay. And reason justification, wrong term solution. Is it clear? This is broadly the approach. Yeah, but long term solution would be again strengthening of internal control. Any systemic issue, corruption, misuse of resources, in the long term solution is strengthening of internal control mechanisms within the organization. Other governance reforms that we have discussed, and a social audit, citizen charter, citizen feedback, okay, all those governance reforms that we have discussed, those will be part of long-term solution. And e-governance, okay, behavioral training, sensitivity training, all these will be part of long-term solution. governance reforms. Okay, we need in 5 minutes to discuss the remaining cases. Today you have a test at 4 o'clock. Tomorrow we will have this
Thank you.